This lecture is in the continuation of metric space part 2, and here we will see what is a bounded metric. Let us start by a very interesting property of metric. If rho be a metric defined on set E, rho dash is defined as rho by 1 plus rho, that means rho dash xy is equal to rho xy upon 1 plus rho xy for xy belongs to E, then we will prove that rho dash is also a metric on E. To prove this, we will prove the four properties satisfied by rho dash to be a metric on E. First property is to prove that rho dash xy is greater than equal to 0. This is obvious because rho is given as a metric on E, therefore rho xy is greater than equal to 0, which implies that rho xy upon 1 plus rho xy is also greater than equal to 0, which shows that rho dash xy is also greater than equal to 0 for xy belongs to E. Second property, to check that rho dash xy equal to 0 if and only if xy, yes, it is true, because given that rho is a metric on E, therefore rho xy is equal to 0 if and only if x equal to y. So rho dash xy equal to 0 means this rho xy upon 1 plus rho xy is equal to 0, which implies rho xy is equal to 0, which implies x is equal to y. And conversely, if you take x equal to y means rho xy equal to 0, because rho is given to be a metric on E, therefore this expression will be 0, which implies rho dash xy is equal to 0. Therefore, second property is also satisfied by metric rho dash on set E. Third property, to check that rho dash xy is equal to rho dash yx. Yes, this is also true, because rho dash xy is equal to rho xy upon 1 plus rho xy. When you interchange the positions of y, x, there will be no change in this value of this expression. That means rho xy upon 1 plus rho xy is equal to rho yx upon 1 plus rho yx, which is equal to rho dash yx. Therefore, third property is also true. To prove this fourth property, we take xyz three points in set E. We start by rho dash xy plus rho dash yz, writing value of rho dash xy, which is equal to rho xy upon 1 plus rho xy. Write value of rho dash yz, which is equal to rho yz upon 1 plus rho yz. Now we will make these denominators of these two terms same, adding one more term, rho yz, to the denominator of first term, adding one more term, rho xy, to the denominator of the second term. Now simplifying this, taking LCM, it becomes rho xy is rho xy plus rho yz upon 1 plus rho xy plus rho yz. And of course, this first term rho xy upon 1 plus rho xy will be greater than equal to rho xy upon 1 plus rho xy plus rho yz, because the denominator of this term is bigger than the denominator of this term. Similarly, rho yz upon 1 plus rho yz is greater than equal to rho yz upon 1 plus rho xy plus rho yz. So sum of these two terms will be greater than equal to sum of these two terms. So simplifying this, we get this is equal to 1 upon 1 plus 1 upon rho xy plus rho yz. Now we are given that rho is a metric on E, that is rho xy plus rho yz is greater than equal to rho xz. Therefore, this term is greater than equal to 1 upon 1 plus 1 upon rho xz. Simplifying this, we obtain rho xz upon 1 plus rho xz, and by definition this is equal to rho dash xz. So here we have proved that rho dash xy plus rho dash yz is greater than equal to rho dash xz whenever x, y, z are the points in set E. So we have seen here that given any metric row on set E, it is always possible to define another metric row dash as row upon 1 plus row, and we can prove that row dash is a metric on E. Now let us define a bounded metric. If there exists a constant k greater than 0 such that rho xy is less than equal to k for every xy belongs to x, then rho is called a bounded metric and the pair x comma rho will be called a bounded metric space. And if it is not so, then it will be called an unbounded metric. And students, one important point to note here that given any metric rho and x, now we can find a bounded metric on x as this. Whenever rho is a metric, we have seen that we can define rho dash as rho upon 1 plus rho, and rho dash is also a metric. Now we know that rho dash xy is equal to rho xy 1 plus rho xy. This expression is, the value of this expression is always less than equal to 1 because the value of denominator is bigger than the, larger than the value of numerator. Therefore, rho dash xy is less than equal to k. K here is 1. So, rho dash xy is less than equal to 1 for every xy belongs to E. Therefore, rho dash is a bounded metric on set E. Next example of a bounded metric. Suppose summation an and from 1 to infinity is a convergent series of positive numbers. Let us take sequence xn and yn and define metric rho xy. So rho is defined on the space of sequences, set of sequences. So rho xy is defined as summation an and from 1 to infinity mod xn minus yn upon 1 plus mod xn minus yn. So we will check that whether there list k greater than 0 for which rho xy is less than equal to k. Yes, we can prove it in this way. Rho xy, which is equal to summation an and from 1 to infinity mod xn minus 1 yn upon 1 plus mod xn minus yn. Now this expression here, mod xn minus yn upon 1 plus mod xn minus yn, is less than equal to 1. Therefore, as a whole, this summation an into this expression is less than equal to summation an and from 1 to infinity. Writing this series, summation an 1 to infinity as k, this expression, this first line can be rewritten as summation an mod xn minus yn upon 1 plus mod xn minus yn is less than equal to summation an and from 1 to infinity, replacing this by defined constant k. So rho xy is less than equal to k for every xy in the given set of sequences. Now, since summation an is a convergent series of positive numbers, it follows that k is a positive real number whose value lies between 0 to infinity. Therefore, we say that rho is a bounded metric. So this is an example of bounded metric. Let us see if there exists a metric which is unbounded. Yes, let us take E as a set of all bounded sequences of real and complex number. We have already discussed this metric rho xy defined as supremum mod xn yn like this, and we have proved this is a metric in the last lecture. So this satisfies all the four properties to be metric. It is a metric on set E. Here we have to check that this metric on set E of sequences, which is a set of sequence, whether real or complex numbers, we'll check that it is bounded or unbounded. To check this, let us consider m to be a positive constant. Let us take AB belongs to E, that means A and B are two sequences defined as sequence AN and sequence BN. Now rho is defined like this. Go to the last slide. Rho is defined as the supremum of mod value. So this value is always positive. Therefore, rho AB is also greater than 0. Now we will try to find a constant k such that k into rho AB is greater than m. Now, writing x as ka, y as kb. So sequence X will be sequence Kn and sequence Y will be sequence Kbn. We get rho xy as this is by definition of rho, that is the supremum of mod xn minus yn, and by definition of xn yn, this is supremum of mod kan minus kbn. K is a constant, we can write it as k equal to k supremum of mod an minus bn, but this value supremum of mod an minus bn for natural numbers, it is defined as rho ab. Therefore, rho xy is equal to k rho ab. But we have seen that rho ab is a positive number, right? So here we will say that k rho ab is greater than some positive number, which implies that rho xy is greater than m. So we have seen that rho xy is greater than m. Hence, rho is not bounded. See, here we have taken m to be any positive constant and we have found a constant k such that k rho ab is greater than m. So, rho is not bounded. So, this is an example of unbounded metric.